You know how forests can draw down CO2 from the atmosphere and store it in their trunks and roots? This is why planting trees is used as a tool in the fight against climate change. But since we can't plant the whole world to trees, we are exploring ways to capture carbon through better agricultural practices. 38% of the Earth's land surface is dedicated to agriculture, so the way we manage crops and soils can have a global impact, particularly on the carbon balance between the atmosphere and the land. So let's break this process down. Plants draw down carbon from the atmosphere through photosynthesis, which is pumped into the soil through their roots. As plants die and decompose, carbon is released back into the atmosphere. So we can think of the soil as a bank account. When the amount of carbon added exceeds the amount lost, our soil carbon stock grows. Specific practices like no-till farming or planting cover crops increase the carbon inputs, decrease outputs, and help build the wealth of carbon in the soil. Most of what we know about the impact of farming on soil carbon comes from controlled field experiments, where researchers plant blocks of crops using different practices. But these experiments are highly controlled, and they rarely match what farmers do on real farms. So I designed a study to understand how innovative farming has changed the amount of carbon stored in the soil on real working farms. I spent the summer driving around Iowa, connecting with farmers who have used no-till and cover crops for around 10 years, like the farm on the right, and then asked them to put me in touch with a neighbor who uses more conventional agriculture, like the farm on the left. We sampled 22 farms across Iowa, collecting soil to a depth of 1 meter so we can understand what's happening deep underground. While we are still processing the hundreds of samples we collected, we are already seeing some interesting differences. No-till and cover crops appear to increase soil carbon, especially in the topsoil. The farmers in our study report that climate-friendly practices help prevent erosion and allow them to use less fertilizers and pesticides on their land. In addition to quantifying how much carbon is stored in the soil on these farms, we also hope to understand why some farmers choose to use practices like no-till and cover crops, while others do not. Because if more farmers adopt these practices, farming can be a meaningful climate change mitigation strategy.